أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Today we will start a series on Surat Al-Fatiha, and we will start with the first hadith narrated in Imam Al-Bukhari. He narrates from Sa'id ibn al-Mu'alla radiyallahu anhu. He's saying that he entered the masjid with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, لَأُعَلِّمَنَّكَ أَعْظَمَ سُورَةٍ فِي الْقُرْآنِ قَبْلَ أَن تَخْرُجَ مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ ثُمَّ أَخَذَ بِيَدِي وعندما أراد أن يخرج قلت له قلت لي ستعلمني أعظم سورة في القرآن فقال الحمد لله رب العالمين تلك السبع المثاني التي بعثت بها. سعيد بن معلى رضي الله عنه narrates that he entered the masjid with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, I will tell you, or I'll teach you, the greatest surah of the Quran before you leave the masjid. And when the Prophet ﷺ was departing and he took the hand of Sa'id ibn al-Mu'alla, Sa'id told him, Ya Rasulullah, you told me you will teach me the best or the greatest surah of the Quran. So the Prophet ﷺ replied, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, that's Surah Al-Fatiha, that is As-Sab' al-Mathani, and this is what I was sent with. This beautiful hadith is turning our attention to Surat Al-Fatiha. Surat Al-Fatiha, as you all know, it's the surah that's most repeated by Muslims because this is the surah that we recite in our daily prayers. So in our five daily prayers, we recite Surat Al-Fatiha. And our prayers is not complete or is not acceptable without reciting Surat Al-Fatiha. This is what the ulama said, this is why it is called As-Sab' al-Mithani. It is seven verses, and Mithani because we keep repeating it, we keep reciting it all the time. And that's what makes our prayers. In fact, in another hadith, Qudusi, as you know, hadith al-Qudusi is narrated by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I have split the prayers between me and my servants. And here, the prayers means Surat Al-Fatiha. So when referring to the prayers, referring to Surat Al-Fatiha, because it's the main part of our salah, our prayers. So how is it split between Allah and us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Hadith Al-Qudsi, it keeps saying, when you say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, you praising me, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawm al-Din, this is the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the first part. This is half of it. And then we say, Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in, you only we worship, you only we seek help from. This is, we're asking something. Then the second half, which is what we are asking from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's our part. First part, so praising Allah. The second part is dua, is request we make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's some of the importance of Surat Al-Fatiha. Surat Al-Fatiha is, in fact, the greatest part of the Quran as per this hadith. And many of the scholars explain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent many books. In many narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah sent many books, many scriptures. And the main of these are three, which is At-Tawrah, Al-Injil, Al-Quran. All of the scriptures revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is summarized in these three books, or three scriptures. And these three are summarized in Al-Quran. Everything in At-Tawrah and Al-Injil is already in the Al-Quran. And this, as per this hadith, the Quran is summarized in Surah Al-Fatiha. Surah Al-Fatiha includes praising Allah, includes prayers, includes requests, includes mentioning of previous people, includes morals, and many things that we will also look at, inshallah, in the upcoming sessions, upcoming hadith, or upcoming series, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the straight path. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa salli Allahumma wa barik ala Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.